Hi, I'm Nita Strauss, and you're watching Duke TV. I started playing guitar after seeing Steve Vai in the movie Crossroads. Seeing Vai in Crossroads just completely opened my mind to the world of guitar, and of course Passion and Warfare was the first album that started everything for me, but I was listening to Steve Vai, Satriani, Marty Friedman, Jason Becker, Paul Gilbert, you know, all the shrapnel artists, Vinnie Moore. And I was always just so drawn to these guitar players that made shred guitar sound fun. Some shred guitar players that just sound so difficult. It doesn't really sound fun, just like, oh God, it sounds really hard. And I was always really drawn to the guitar players that were like, that sounds exciting, I want to learn how to do that. You know, I recorded most of Control Chaos while I was on tour with Alice Cooper in 2018, so it makes sense I'm already working on the follow-up in 2019. As a guitar player, I'm just happy to play. You know, I don't feel like I have this dying, burning need that I need to get these songs out. I'd like to, but I get to express myself on stage every day, so that satisfies me. But I want to work on the songs while I'm on tour because this is the available time that I have. We've got such iconic guitar players that have been in this band. It's just such an honor for me to get to be one of them. Joe Satriani and Steve Vai did the two solos in Feed My Frankenstein. Paul Petrelli in Trash Is the World. Red B, She Came. It's really cool to get to know Kane now, not just as a hero, but as a friend. And we met at Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp. We were counselors at Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp, and I was so honored to do a little solo on his album. And actually, I was lucky enough that when we added these songs in, you know, Teenage Frankenstein and Bed of Nails, Roses on White Lace, especially Roses on White Lace, which is really, really challenging solo, I was able to reach out to Kane. And I said, Liz, this one part, what did you do? How did you play it? And actually, he sent me a recording of him playing it so I can play it exactly like him, which is, how many times do you get the opportunity? Two days of rehearsal we have with the stage. I think many bands would take 2 weeks, 1 month to rehearse something like that, but I think it's a compliment for us that they think that our band, you know, me, Ryan, Tommy, Chuck, and Glenn are good enough that we can just do it in 2 days. So, you know, we definitely take the first few days of the tour to work it out and figure out, okay, baby's gonna go left, so I'm gonna go right, and he's gonna go to the front, so I'm gonna go to the back. But by and large, it's all done, you know, pretty much on the fly. The props we use on stage, they're all real. You know, swords and knives and whips and stuff, it's all sharp. So I've gotten sliced and diced. And the funniest injury I think I had was, you know, we have the big balloons at the end, and Alice pops it with the sword. But the balloons are tied with a zip tie. So actually, the zip tie hit me in the face and I got a bloody lip. It looked really cool, like I got in a fight. Like, oh, what happened to you? I'm like, balloon. I got beat up by a balloon, no big deal. That's how Orianthi, when she played foul, she had a couple small scratches of, you know, lipstick or something and the fake blood on her face, and I thought, how can I take it to the extreme? So now, of course, you see me, I'm just covered in paint, head to toe. There's a little story, and I've never told it, but I always like to see if people guess, you know, because there's a bit of a story behind, like, where the markings of the blood are. So maybe if you guys are watching, you look at photos or videos, maybe you can guess.